Hi, I'm Hein, DIYvan, and we're here in the Skunk Works facility of DIYvan. It's our barn. I got my Sprinter in here, I got the Transit in here, and I just wanted to show you some little tricks I found out I could do with these fender liners that I got just recently. I've installed the front fender liners on this van, and they make a great big difference. We came out with some mud flaps that go along with those. Those are awesome. I had previously put the WeatherTech mud flaps on, but then I changed out to our mud flaps in the front. I'm still going to use the rear WeatherTech mud flaps, and then I'm just going to today put these liners into the rear fender wells. But we drive to the mountain with our van a lot, and make the gravel from the snowy roads hitting the fenders or the wheel tubs makes a lot of noise. So we're hoping these would help. But if I put some Thinsulate on the back of these, which I'm going to show you how I'm doing that, then that should make even a bigger difference. And this is the AU4002-5. It's 1 inch thick, and it's got scrim on both sides. So it's going to be more resilient and durable underneath the van, even though it's going to be pretty much entirely coated or covered with these fender liners. So it's going to go between the fender liner and the wheel tub that's in the van already. So one of the things I want to show you with these fender liners is that because I've used the WeatherTech floor or the WeatherTech mud flaps, they have a nut that goes back behind here. And so with the liners in there, I won't be able to access to put that nut back on. So what I've done is enlarge those holes a little bit and put some quarter 20 clip nuts on there instead. That'll give me access, that'll give me something to screw these screws into that hold the mud flap. So that's just one little step that you gotta do if you want to put the fender liners in. So let me show you how I'm going to basically coat the back of these with some Thinsulate. So I've got a piece of Thinsulate here. If you were to buy a piece from us about a 5 foot length, 60 inches wide, this is what I got here. It's actually about a little under two feet wide. I've already cut sort of a piece to start with. So all I'm really going to do is get my spray adhesive. I'm actually using the Gorilla spray adhesive. It works great for this. I bought a bunch of it, so I have it. So all I'm going to do is just start spraying the backside of the liner, of the plastic liner. And I'm going to put a lot on here. I want it to stick super good. And I'm just going to wrap this, basically upholster it with the Thinsulate. Okay, so spray that half part. I'm just going to spray over here. Again, I'm kind of laying it on pretty heavy. I'm going over it a number of times. Just going to spray part of it for now, and then I'm going to start wrapping it and continue to spray more of it. So that's a good starting point. I got some on here now. Maybe a little bit more on this edge, up by the sides. Okay, I really do need to let that kind of air dry a little bit so it gets sticky. So you can see a bit in the camera. So all I'm going to do is basically line up this edge of the liner with this bottom edge of the Thinsulate, just right along that sort of that edge. And I'm kind of centering it this way because I'm going to be wrapping the sides as well. So I'm just going to kind of lay that down. Okay, so that's how I'm starting. Now, I want to wrap this around, but then I'm going to have to cut some pieces out here. So what I'm going to do next is just continue to wrap that top part, spray some more adhesive on here. Spray some more on the Thinsulate. Again, I'm using it pretty heavy. Probably don't need to put quite that much on. Again, need to drop to let it air dry a little bit before it sticks. So wrap that on. Now I'm going to continue over here. You can see where I've got a pleat that I'm going to have to cut out. Probably could have just sprayed this right off the bat. Kind of do it in steps here so you can kind of follow along on how I'm doing it. I'm going to have this extra material here at the corner. So what I need to do, actually, let me just pull this back down just a little bit. Cut this first. I'll lay that back down. Lay this down. And now you can see I got this overlap here. So all I'm going to do is cut that off. It's kind of a little bit hard to hold on to while you're doing this. Probably could do it. This is basically my upholstery skills coming into play here. So I can't say that I'm a professional upholsterer, but I've kind of figured some things out over the years. You know, I've found that it's always a little bit better to cut a little more off than to cut too much off. So when you're cutting, just leave yourself a little extra so you can trim, basically trim it to fit. So you see now where I've got this basically coming together. And I'm going to do the same thing over here, but just so I can show you the process without doing too much extra video here, I'm going to cut this along that edge. Like so, right? Got a little bit more trimming to do here. I know that this part of the fender liner hangs down below the wheel tub. You can see where there's this kind of bend in it, and that's where I'm going to stop my Thinsulate. So cut that off. So there we go. So I've got that ready. Now, one of the last things I'll do, and I'm running out of video time here, but I'll spray this edge with a little 3-inch, with a little bit of spray in this end. And then I'm gonna apply some cloth electrical tape to that seam just to kind of cover it a little bit better. See how that can work? It's just basically a cloth electrical tape that you get on Amazon. Now come on over here because I want to show you one little detail that I'm going to do. I actually already did the fender well on this side. So it's already in. It's got the Thinsulate in there. And on, I don't know if you can see, but there's a couple of little divots where they want you to put screws in it. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take this piece of angle. So I made a little piece of angle out of aluminum angle. It's 1 by 1 inch by 16 thick. I'm just going to lay that in there and screw that in so that that holds that plastic a little better than just two screws. So, looks like it'll work really good. I'll finish up that other side, and should be a lot quieter up on the mountain with the gravel hitting that fender tub now with that in there. Thanks for watching.